Martial law era activist Renato Constantino Jr. has passed away. He was 79. His family confirmed that Constantino died Thursday. He was the son of late historian Renato Constantino Sr. and father of our colleague Carmina Constantino. A wake will be held starting April 8th until April 10 in Quezon City.
Our numbers that matter this Friday, something on education. A new report finds 3.6 billion people live in 27 countries and territories where academic freedom is restricted. That is about 45.5% of the world's population. The Academic Freedom Index lists the Philippines among such places, along with the US and the UK. The report did not elaborate per country, but its researchers have noted that university campuses have become places of polarization and have called for calm and evidence-based debates on campus.
Filipinos are most unhappy with the government's efforts to curb inflation. A Pulse Asia survey found the Marcos administration got a net approval rating of negative 66 in controlling inflation, which remains the top national concern. It also obtained a negative net approval rating in reducing poverty, fighting graft and corruption, addressing involuntary hunger, and increasing workers' pay. Meanwhile, the government fared the best in protecting the welfare of OFWs, calamity response, and promoting peace. The survey was conducted from March 6 to 10. A UN agency sees the Philippine economy growing by 6% this year, a figure within government's GDP target range of 6 to 7%. This projection from the United Nations Economic and Social Commission for Asia and the Pacific is higher than its initial forecast of 5.7% issued in April last year. That puts the Philippine economy as the second fastest in the Southeast Asian region, lower only to Cambodia. As for inflation, the report also expects the Philippine Consumer Price Index to settle within the government's target this year at 3.8%. Nearly 20 local government units in the Philippines are under a state of calamity due to the prevailing El Niño phenomenon. These include Oriental Mindoro, some municipalities in Occidental Mindoro, Palawan, Romblon, Ifugao, Antique, and Zamboanga City. The country's El Niño Task Force says more areas plan to follow suit. The Philippine government has earlier warned the weather event, which is expected to persist until May, is seen to affect over 80 provinces by the end of this month, sparing only two provinces. The Philippines' top economist vows to address the effects of adverse weather conditions on prices following the uptick in inflation. NEDA Secretary Arsenio Balisacan says government is closely monitoring the effects of the ongoing El Niño phenomenon on the supply of key commodities. The weather event has caused over 2 billion pesos in crop damage in the Philippines. Balisacan adds preparations aimed at mitigating the effects of La Niña are underway. The government has said La Niña might start in June, increasing the possibility of more storms ravaging the country by the last quarter of the year.